What is up, my adventure crew? Nick Morris here. Welcome to another episode of Real Adventures Hawaii. On today's episode, it's going to be a fast one. I'm just going to show you how to prepare fresh Hawaiian octopus or Hawaiian taco. It works for pretty much any type of taco. But if it is your first time here, welcome aboard. If you're returning, welcome back aboard. If you can, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell notification and get notified whenever I post videos like this or fishing videos. But today's a short one. Me and my son actually caught this taco about a month ago. It's always been taught to me to actually throw the taco in a freezer. It actually helps to tenderize the meat because the meat's kind of rubbery if you just cook it right away. We're going to clean it and then we're going to show you how to get the slime off of it to prepare it for cooking. We're going to soak it, cook it on the grill. Alright guys, here we go. Let's get to the cleaning. Oh, the bag's leaking. So I don't know what happened there. I guess my camera didn't hit the record button. All I did so far was I took the head, okay, and put it back together how it was. I guess I totally forgot the record button. We have all the legs, we have the head. I cut deep enough on the head that when I took off the head, I cut out the beak area also. So that's where the beak is on the inside mouth. We're gonna put this in our bowl because we have to get the slime off that next. We have the head here, we're gonna eat the head. I cut off the eye area because I'm not gonna eat that eye area. You can, there's nothing wrong with it.
We can eat it?
Yeah, you can, we're not gonna eat it.
Oh, you cannot poke that part.
Yeah, you don't wanna poke the ink sac, very good to me, right?
I knew it was the ink sac.
Yeah, if you poke the ink sac, it's gonna make a big mess in here.
Okay, so. I wanna see what happens.
No, it's gonna stain everything.
Why? It'll stain your camera.
So I'm just kinda trying to avoid using both hands because I don't want to get my hand all dirty and try and touch my camera with one hand, but here we go.
Oops. Ew.
So I'm just gonna rip the guts out. Okay. It should come out fairly easy. Just be very careful with that ink sac. You do not wanna get that ink sac to rupture, or else you're gonna have a mess.
Yeah, so remember, and you, if you're doing it with a kid, you need an adult to help you.
Yeah, you need an adult to help you. Very good, man.
Yeah, or you just cut your hand off, and then you need to call 911 for no reason.
So throw this in here. This is all rubbish.
And then you grow a new hand, and blah blah blah.
Okay, be quiet, okay? Nobody wants to hear your stories about growing a new hand. Okay, so we have the head here. The head, and we have the legs.
Call me when you're ready.
Okay, let me go wash this off, clean this area up, and we'll be right back.
Okay, I'm gonna ride.
So we have the octopus in this bowl. Okay. Now the trick to get the slime off, okay, is any type of coarse rock salt or sea salt. We use Hawaiian sea salt for this, okay? And we're gonna kind of spread it liberally, if that's the right word for this. On the taco itself, and we're just gonna mash it up, and that's
it.
You want me to do this part?
Why?
Because I have to mash it, okay? So what you gotta do is just, in Hawaii we call it loming, but it's pretty much just mashing it up. You massage the taco. Can you hear it? Getting all that slime off. So salt helps to wash all the slime off, okay? And this is an important part of the process because you don't want to eat the taco all slimy.
Ew, that would be gross. Yeah.
Yeah. So we're gonna do
this. Your mouth will be all drooly.
So we're gonna do this about 3 or 4 times, till there's like no slime on it, and then we're gonna soak it and grill it. So let's speed through this process, cause nobody wants to just keep watching this, right? So this is pretty much my final rinse with the salt on this guy. It's pretty. There's like no slime on this guy, right? It's slime free. So I'm gonna rinse it off and then we'll come right back. It's completely slime free. This head is okay the way it is. To get ready for marination, it's fine like this. We split it open, we take the guts out. The legs and stuff. What you can do is you can cut into like single leg pieces if you want. There's a number of ways you can do this, but preferred method is individual legs. It's easier to put on the grill. So I'll take this in the house and we'll actually go soak it. So be right back. So we got our taco here in the bowl. To marinate this, we're going to use a very basic Aloha Shoyu teriyaki sauce. It's a product made locally over here on Hawaii. They pretty much sell it everywhere. Walmart, everywhere. And it's fairly cheap, not too expensive. We'll put our taco in a Ziploc bag just to make it a little easier and a little easier to clean up. We'll put about a quarter cup to maybe a half a cup of the teriyaki sauce just enough to cover the taco. We'll put it in the fridge and we'll let it soak for about an hour to 2 hours. And then from there, it'll be ready to cook. After letting the taco marinate in the fridge for about an hour and a half, I prepared a grill and I brought it outside and I put it on a straight hot grill. Normally, when we catch taco, I normally just freeze them and I use them for bait. Most of the time, Damien likes to eat a couple of the suckers off on the tacos raw. He likes to do that. He thinks it's funny. But this is the first time he actually got to eat it off the grill like this. He was super excited to try it out, and he really likes his seafood. So he kind of just stuck around and kept asking me, is it done yet? Is it done yet? Is it done yet? Until it was finally done.
Oh, no. Good piece.
Can't eat that. Come on, cut it. Cut them small.
So thanks to my executive chef, Damien, for his help today. There's our taco. Cheers. You good? That's a taco you caught? Huh? Thanks, guys. As always, tight lines, stay fishing, and I'll see you on the water. Aloha, guys. Come on.